QDPI Student Ambassador Ms. Srija Ghosh, presently studying in Cambridge School, Kiarpuram, Bangalore, has developed a project gesture to speech to assist differently abled people. Let us know more on this project. I must appreciate your enthusiasm on building interesting projects. The latest one is gesture to speech to assist differently abled people. How did this idea of gesture to speech come to you?
First thing is, there was the APDS sensor and it really fascinated me because I never saw such a sensor before. And in the kit, that was the unique sensor according to me because it was like all in one. It had lots of sensors in it. But unfortunately, Code2Play didn't have that facility to work with the APDS sensors. As soon as I got the information, I got the news that the APDS sensor is available, I got excited and I started thinking about projects which can be done using the APDS sensor. Now, there was one thing which was the gesture sensor, and I don't know why, but it really made me happy and I thought I have to make a project no matter what with the gesture sensor. So that night, I was thinking about the different things I can do with the gesture sensor. And again, I always try to think for a problem statement and then try to find a solution for that problem, which can actually be solved with my QTPI robotics kit, a prototype. Then while thinking, I came across this idea where I can actually convert the gesture to speech. And then the problem statement would be to assist differently abled people who can't see nor speak. So if they can't see nor speak, they won't be able to express their ideas or express their views, opinions. They won't be able to express anything until and unless they know sign language. But let's say they don't, and it's difficult for them to learn it because they're already blind and they can't speak. So if they can't see, as we know, when we see, we learn better. Just by hearing, it's close to impossible to learn something so fast. Hence, this, I think, will be helpful for them to express their views.
Wonderful. I see a very interesting objective behind what you're trying to arrive to. But I also understand that there are different kind of gestures used. So how many gestures did you use and how did you arrive to this gesture signs you use, especially when you move from right to left, left to right? And I also understand that you go from top to down, something like this, and you also go closure. So what does these mean? How did you arrive for these gestures?
Okay, so there are totally 6 gestures, and they are not like these kind of gestures which are there in sign language. These are very simple. It's just moving from one place to another. So when you move your hand like this, it's right, the other way left. When you move it this way, it's up, the other side it's down. And there are 2 more things called far and near. So totally 6 gestures: right, left, up and down, far and near. So these are the different gestures. Now, as we know, there are just 26 alphabets. And how are we going to convey all the 26 alphabets with just 6 sensors? So that was one problem. And I thought over and over again. Then I thought, why not group them? So that with one gesture itself, I can cover a bulk of the alphabets. That is how I use those 6 gestures to convey the messages.
So that means, ideally, you divided 6 or 7 into one group.
Okay. Around 6 or 7. I actually used 4 gestures, that is right, left, up and down. And those were the gestures I used for the alphabets to convey the letters. Far and near, I used it for something else. Now, we have 2 keys on our keyboard, that is enter and space. So whenever we type a sentence, that is a group of different words, to differentiate between the different words, we need a space. So that's why the gesture near is for space and gesture far is for enter. Now, as there are just 4 gestures which I can use for the alphabets, I need to keep shuffling between them. Once I keep shuffling between them, there has to be some key to print it on the phone or the device. So that's when the gesture far comes handy. That is how I use the gesture far to enter, near to space, and the others I use it to shuffle between the different alphabets.
Okay, I also would like to understand, are these gestures universal, the way you would move from one direction to other direction?
It's not exactly universal. Not everybody know them. It's easy to understand.
Okay, so it is easy for somebody who's differently abled to follow this gestures so that they will achieve an objective out of it. Is it right?
Yeah, the thing is, it might be time consuming. As I said, there are just four gestures, so we have to keep shuffling. It might be time consuming. Let's say it's the last letter of the group. Let's say we have to keep moving right for 7 times and then go far, that is up to enter it, and then do it again. I know it's a bit of a tedious process, but I'll say it's easy to learn. It's not like sign language. It's just 6 gestures and they can achieve their objective with it.
Okay. One of the objective, I understand what you wanted to achieve through this was to print a name, right? Like let's take your example, Srija. It starts with the alphabet S, R, I, J, A. Is it right?
Yes.
Yeah. Now my question to you is to understand, one is that when you move your hands one particular direction again and again, you print those names and their name appears overall. Now, as you mentioned, the objective of the problem statement for your project was somebody who cannot see and somebody who cannot hear. Am I right?
No, somebody who can't see nor speak.
How do I know what I've written is what I wanted it to be?
Yeah. So this is where the limit switch, which I have comes into use. So limit switch, physical things are easy to feel, and limit switch, it has a pointy kind of, it has a projection and we can easily click it. Even if the person can't see, can easily click on it. The limit switch comes into use here, that whenever I click on the limit switch, whatever I've written down, whatever I have tried to convey using the gestures will be spoken out. So here I've actually used the text to speech converter in Code to Play to go into more details. So whatever I've written, the device speaks it out so that even the person can hear it.
Okay, now if you correctly understand, say I have done these gestures and my name is printed, then I press something called a limit switch, right? And then it says out what has been printed.
Exactly.
Now, how many times will it say it? Will it say it one times or many times?
It depends on the number of times you click on it. If you click on it once, it just tells it once. If you click on it 10 times, it tells it out 10 times.
Okay, there's no limit for the limit switch.
No, there's no limit for the limit switch, yeah.
Okay, wonderful. Okay, so that way it will ensure that somebody who has typed what they want to type is right and it is saying
yes.
Right? But
yes,
will also tell us this, the way it is written is right word, the alphabets. Let's say I try to print my name Santosh, I say N-T-O-S-H. Let's say one of my gestures has not gone right and it is typed as S-A-M-T-O-S-H. Will it help me know whether my name is right or wrong, the way it is printed?
Yeah. Yeah, when you click on it, you can listen to it. And another thing I forgot to mention is actually there are 2 limit switches, one towards the right and one towards the left. The other limit switch is to backspace, basically. So when you click on it, here what I have done is I made a list, if you know what a list is. So list has different boxes. Let's just imagine it has lots of boxes and each box contains of one letter. Now, when you click on the limit switch, which is towards your right, a one box gets erased. So that is how it works. So that is how you can click on backspace. Again, when you think of it as a practically, it does sound a bit something which is difficult. Theoretically, it seems easy, but this is what I can do with the gesture sensor I have.
Or do you suggest something else? I'm trying to ask you and understand this. Let's say I move my hand in one direction, then I type, let's say yes, okay, of my name, the first alphabet. And then can I press the limit switch and know what is being typed?
Yeah. So let's say you did S. Yeah, that is another good idea. So you can check each and every letter that you have written. Let's say give S, you click on the limit switch, the text to speech tells it out. Now, the problem is when you click on R, the text to speech or the limit switch, when you click on it, doesn't speak R. Includes S and R, so maybe the accent becomes sir or something. So that is one thing, but you can understand, okay, that's S and that's R. So that is how you can cross check.
Okay. Do you see any larger application of such kind of a project which you're building? Do you see beyond my writing my name, but there is going to be larger application?
Yeah. Stephen Hawking is a very famous person. You know that he was paralyzed, neuromuscular disease. Don't know the exact scientific name, but it caused him to actually not be able to move his muscles, not even his cheek muscles, tongue muscles. It worsened as time passed by. As he was a great scientist, few engineers tried to make something by which he can speak out. He can convey his messages. Even if his lips and tongues weren't moving, only his cheek muscles moved a bit. So lots of sensors and actuators were attached to his face and other things. And when his cheek muscle movement actually conveyed whatever he wants to say. This is just the starting, probably, this what I have made. I can keep improvising on it to make it better.
Yes, Shrija Ghosh, I think it's very interesting to hear a big, very good beginning on a project which will help differently able people and help them at least realize that, okay, they can think of and typing their names and also hearing out what they say. And I wish that you continue building on this project and keep this enthusiasm ahead so that we see more interesting people coming from you. Thank you very much for your valuable time. And
thanks.
It was wonderful talking to you. Stay safe, healthy and happy.